Red Tusty, hi.
Hello, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. Let's talk about Jedi Academy, a new chapter in the Jedi Knight series. First of all, what can you tell us about the storyline?
Well, there's a new evil in the galaxy, and you start off as a student at Luke Skywalker's Academy. So he's given you a variety of missions to really restore order. This is after Return of the Jedi, so mostly the rebellion is in charge, but there are still a lot of criminal activity.
Okay, let's talk about the gameplay itself. How has it evolved?
The gameplay is you start off as a student, and you're given a lot of options. You can choose what kind of character you want, what race, what gender, also what type of saber you're wielding. You can wield a single saber, two sabers, one saber in each hand, or a Darth Maul type saber, which is a staff saber. We also have a lot of new vehicles, and we have a new multiplayer mode, Siege mode, which is character classes. Like, for example, you could be a Jedi and I could be a demolitionist, and we can help each other out to achieve a mission objective.
The game starts in the Jedi Knight Academy, but after that, where do we go?
Well, it's very interesting because after you get the basic training, Luke kind of says to you, okay, there's a lot of things happening in the galaxies. Sometimes you're going to Tatooine and trying to find out information, and you meet up with Chewbacca, and you get to fight in the hangar right along the Falcon. Sometimes you're going to places like Hoth, seeing what's happening there. There's another location where there's a crime lord, and he's gathering up civilians, and he's feeding them to his rancor, and he's allowing people to bet on him. So you're going there to stop him from doing that and rescue the people. So there's a lot of different kinds of missions that you can play.
What types of foe are we going to face, and what type of weapon are we going to battle them?
Yes, of course. There will be the standard stormtroopers. The remnants of the old Empire will be there. In addition to that, we have some of the Reborn that you had in Jedi Outcast, which are people that are semi-proficient in the use of the Force and saber fighting, but they're not Jedis by any stretch of the means. And of course, there will be Dark Jedis, people that have a strong understanding of the Force, and they're very powerful foes.
In the previous title, our character was on the brink of going to the dark side and returning to... In this title, is the Force powers, are there any from the light side?
Well, after you complete each mission, you're actually given a choice of either choosing a light Force power or a dark Force power. So, really, you can pick a lot of dark Force powers or light Force powers. It's not really the Force power itself, it's how you use it, whether you're good or bad in this game.
Thank you very much, Brett.